Good luck to you three this weekend. Made it to state, so the pressure's off. So all you gotta do is go out there, wrestle your style, your match. If you do that, there's not a doubt in my mind that you guys are gonna end up on the podium.
Hey guys, just wanted to congratulate you on making it to state. I hope you realize how big of an achievement that is. Not everybody gets to go to state, but just go out there and do your best and wrestle hard, wrestle your matches. And remember, it's state, anything can happen. Don't look at a person's record and judge them by that. Just go, stay calm, do your best, and hopefully you'll bring home some hardware.
Hey guys, so I want to just congratulate you guys on making it to state wrestling. That is a big accomplishment that was made. You three carried on a great tradition here at St. Francis High School with carrying on 85 years of having someone qualify for state. Pretty impressive. Guys, just go out there and wrestle your way. Don't let your opponent take control. Do what you need to do. I don't see the reason that any of you shouldn't place at state. You guys had a tough regionals and made it through. It was fun to watch you guys at wrestling last weekend at regionals. I can't wait for this weekend. Good luck, guys.
Hey, St. Francis Wrestling. Congratulations on the season and what's to come at the state tournament. This is Zach Ginger. I was graduating in 2013, and I was Coach Wood's first state placer. I just wanted to say that we're rooting for you, all of St. Francis Wrestling. You've got quite the tradition. Coach Lloyd likes to talk about it. It's something that if you ever wrestle for St. Francis, you like to talk about. If you go to the school, any school you go to, you're going to see all the pictures up, all the people that have placed at state or done something for the school. You know, most of those schools have one or two, maybe if they're a good school, 10, 15 guys that are in singlets and they did something for the sport and wrestling. St. Francis has 99 state champions and countless other state placers. We have one of the most decorated team title teams in the state as well. So I just want to know that we're rooting for you guys, everybody that wrestles for St. Francis right now. And we follow you guys. We're excited for you. Congratulations. Keep up the good work, guys.
Hey, guys. My name is Jordan Ginger. I graduated from St. Francis High School in 2007. What St. Francis Wrestling means to me, as long as I can remember, all I wanted to be was a wrestler at St. Francis. I remember being a little kid and listening to some of the older guys tell stories, and that's not just guys in high school, it was guys our dad's age, sit around, tell old wrestling stories. And at that time period in wrestling, watching state championship teams go through with wrestlers that did very well at the time. I can just remember going to PAC gyms, and it was the event to go to. And particularly the state meet, I remember even as a kid, just my attention span couldn't be held for much, but I remember certain wrestling matches with certain people drew my attention and had a big impression on me at that point in my life. I remember watching people like Jim Keller, Kelly Gable, Billy Gable, Tyler Crine. And I was pretty young, but still remember those matches, and it had just a big impression on what that history meant to me, as far as the guys before me. And I just remember thinking in high school, going into the state tournament, like all these people have been there before. This is an event that is special, not just to me, but to everybody else around me. You could feel that. That's just something, if anything, that you guys could take away from it would be that it's just one of the funner events I ever competed in, and one of the funnest places I have memories from. And just know that you have the whole town and community behind you as far as alumni like me that will be paying attention and curious to see how you guys do. This is just a fun event. I hope you guys relax and Get out there. Don't let Coach Lloyd be too hard on you. But, yeah, just have fun and hope you enjoy the weekend.
Hey, guys. This is Gabe Walls, class of 2005. I just wanted to tune in and wish you guys the best of luck at state wrestling this weekend. You're carrying the torch of a very long, rich tradition. So just work hard in your preparation and on the mats. Leave it all out there. And good luck. Take state.
Gentlemen, congratulations on making it to state. You got a St. Francis native all the way out in Kansas City that's paying attention to you and wishing you guys the best. Tiernan, this is your last shot, bud. Go ahead and get yourself a medal and get a reward for all the hard work you've put in. Shattered and Garen, man, this is just the start for you guys, but don't take anything for granted. You never know what's coming down that chute, and this may be your only shot at state that you get. So go out there. Don't hold back. Take advantage of every opportunity that you can and just pressure and bring home. Make everyone happy back in St. Francis. Get your name on that huge board full of legacy and legends in St. Francis that have gone on to state and brought home a little piece of history for themselves. Good luck, fellas.
Hey, Billy Gable here. I graduated in 1996 from St. Francis High School. maybe my picture is still on the wall, maybe not. But I was blessed. My dad was head coach there for 32 years, and I was blessed to be the first four-time state champ, not only of the high school, but of 3-2-1A history. And I would just tell you that I, you know, it was with a lot of hard work, but a lot of positive direction. And from the history just coming from St. Francis, like when we walked on the mat, we knew, and by the way, 1996, we won the state title as a team. And so we knew that when you walk out on the mat, people knew where you were from. You were from St. Francis. And they knew St. Francis and the type of athlete and wrestler that comes from St. Francis. And so there's a lot of tradition, a lot of history there. And that means something when you step foot on the mat. You wrestle with a lot of stuff behind you. So you can walk out with confidence knowing that not only are you a good wrestler, but you're an Indian, and there's a lot of people behind you that paved the way for you. So, guys, as I take my team to the Colorado State Championship this weekend, in hopes to do really well with them, I wish you the best.
Hey, guys, I want to say congratulations on qualifying for state. It took a lot of hard work to get to where you're now at, and I just want to let you know I've been following along this year, and I'll be following along this weekend. Excited to see how you do. So you're a part of a long and storied tradition of St. Francis wrestling, and so we're with you. We're in your corner. Go for it. Don't hold back. And you've put in a lot of hard work again, so don't hold anything back now. And good luck, and we'll be following along.
Hey, Garrett, Tiernan, and Shadron, I want to start by saying congratulations on being the Indians' latest men to qualify for state. The most stressful part is over, and the fun part starts now. Looking back, when I was your age, you don't think about what it really means to be part of a tradition that's behind you. It is a great thing. This is the 40th anniversary of my first state title, and now I look at my name on the wall, and the names of the men that went before me, and the names of the men who helped me and did it with me, and the men after me, including my son, Coach Lloyd, who is carrying on the tradition. It makes me proud to be a part of. So good luck, and just know we are behind you. Do your best and fight till the whistle blows. And to the coaches, we are proud of you and glad to have two Christian men coaching these young men. Good luck, and coach them up.
So you thought it was the end of the story. Well, you thought wrong. In fact, it's far from over. That was the easy part. Now it's time to redefine the grind.
Never let somebody tell you you can't do something. You got a dream, you got to protect it. People can't do something themselves, they want to tell you you can't do it. You want something, go get it. Period.
So the old man said, I thought you said you wanted to be successful. He said, I do. He said, walk a little further. He came, dropped his head in, held him down, hold him down. My man didn't scratch it, holding him down. He had him held down just before my man was about to pass out. He raised him up. He said, when you were underwater, what did you want to do? He told the guy, he said, when you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful.
It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is going to hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. Now, if you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you got to be willing to take the hits. And not pointing fingers saying you ain't where you want to be because of him or her or anybody. Cowards do that, and that ain't you. You're better than that.
The only thing you care about when you're trying to breathe is to get some fresh air. That's it. And when you get to the point where all you want to do is be successful as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful. And I'm here to tell you, number one, that most of you say you want to be successful, but you don't want it bad. You just kind of want it. I said, look, don't cry to give up. Cry to keep going. Don't cry to quit. You already in pain. You already hurt. Get a reward from it. Don't go to sleep until you succeed. Listen to me. The problem is you ain't never felt no pain before. You're soft. It's a soft generation. You quit on everything. Our people did not quit. Listen to me. Pain is temporary. It may last for a minute, or an hour, or a day, or even a year. But eventually, it will subside. And something else will take its place. If I quit, however, it will last forever. But I'm exactly where I want to be, because I realize I gotta commit my very being to this thing. I gotta breathe it, I gotta eat it, I gotta sleep it. And until you get there, you will never be successful in life. And once you get there, I guarantee you, the world is yours. To work hard, you need to have whatever it is you want.